In the red corner, he stands at 6 feet, 1 inch tall, and tips the scales officially at 168.7 pounds. He is fighting out of Prestatyn, Wales, and is representing Hammer MMA. And this is his professional MMA debut. Please make some noise for Bobby Palette. Opposite him in the cage, in the blue corner, he stands at 6 feet, 2 inches tall, and tips the scales officially at 170.4 pounds. He is fighting out of Warrington, England, and is representing Supremacy Fight Academy with a professional mixed martial arts record of 0 wins and 1 defeat. Make some noise for Matthew Bonner!
Legend, welcome back to Cage Warriors, the Academy Northwest. I'm Jamie the Haymaker Hay, here with Jay, the Blast Furnace.
Yeah, second professional fight of the night, Bobby Palette from Hammer, making his professional debut after a very successful amateur career, and Matthew Bonner from Supremacy, who's at 0-1 as it stands, but a very tough fighter with some good wins at amateur himself. So yeah, potentially a good bout on the cards.
Tough first bout for Bobby and a tough second bout for Bonner.
Yeah, credit to both guys for taking this fight at this stage. Oh, good straight left to the body for Palette, trying to set up the one to the head there afterwards.
Both quite a big welterweights as well, these two. Bobby's gone up from lightweight in recent times.
Yeah, moved up from lightweight, but looks the part at welterweight, definitely. Doesn't look a small guy for the weight, looks well sized for the weight.
Yeah, seems to really filled out since he's gone up there. Ooh, oh, nice body kick there.
Looking to rip that rear leg to the body.
Bonner there, gritting his teeth, moving forward.
Yeah, tough guy. You can eat the shots and still keep plowing forward. That's one of the traits you'll see. Interesting to see how both guys deal with the 5 minute rounds after having most of the experience fighting over 3 minutes.
Yeah, there seems to have been a bit of bad blood between these two on the build-up to this and all. Neither seem to like each other.
And you see Bonner there, he just presses forward. Palette looking sharp and landing some good shots, but Bonner unfazed by it. You know, his face doesn't seem to change. He just keeps walking him down.
Yeah, every time we see Bonner, he seems to be the same sort of fight where he'll take the shots, but he's very hard to put down. So if Bobby can put him down, it'd be a big sort of win for him, but great head kick there from Bonner.
Yeah, he's upping his own output a little bit, but he's on the back foot there as Palette moves forward.
Yeah, Bobby's moving forward, taking the centre of the cage, really, and just working his way round.
Went in for that straight left, but Bonner was ready and waiting for it with a few shots. Palette, a nice little flurry there, a couple of good shots to the body. A left hand and a knee.
Good take there. Go watch that guillotine though.
Yeah, Palette looks to have it. And well, he left the guillotine, went to the underhooks to stay on his feet.
Yeah, this is where Bobby's now going to put the pressure on up against the cage and see what he can do. Nice elbow, nice short elbow there from Bonner though.
Yeah, and that's been something Palette's never felt before. So he's probably unaware of that shot coming from that position. But now he can use his own on top inside the guard. Free the arms, little short elbows. Makes a big difference fighting, going from amateur to pro when someone can start clunking him in from a short distance.
And not just that, clunking him in for 5 minutes as well.
Yeah, Bonner looking for the sweep there as Palette stands up.
Great balance there.
Opportunity to pass if he can get his hips in.
Upster, yeah, I think he missed the trick there. I think he should have dragged that leg across and tried to take that side control.
Yeah, difference is what Palette will find out is, you know, at amateur you need quite a lot of space to land a punch from inside the guard, but you know, an elbow takes millimeters and can do damage, so it opens up a tool that you never had before.
Yeah, this is good work from Bobby though in the top position now. He's got to watch the arm.
Oh, Bonner gone for the arm,
and he's got that,
and it looks tight. Extending it, Palette trying to work his way out, using his feet to try and escape. His elbow might be free, is it? I think his elbow might be out of there now.
That was a great attempt, but fantastic work from Bobby.
Great
to not give up to that.
Bonner from nowhere throwing the submission up. And that now is going to make Bobby Pallett think twice about what he's doing from the top position.
Yeah, that was a lot of energy exerted from both guys as well.
Oh, good knee to the body.
Knees to the head allowed as well.
And Pallett can elbow from there. Nice to push the face away and let it drop back into the elbow from that clinch.
He's grabbing that wrist, trying to use that wrist control. But Bobby just in control on the up against the cage, really. Bit of clinch work up against the cage and all.
Yeah, he's going to try and rip that leg out for the takedown, but Bonner looking for a Kimura grip.
Looking for that Kimura. He's got the grip on, but he's let that go.
Let it go, chopping away with the short elbows again. I remember my first pro, well, my second pro fight, because the first one never even went to the ground, but the second one, I was in someone's garden, they started elbowing me, and I just totally forgot. It's like the shock, and there goes Bonner for the arm again. Pallett tries to hammer fist his way out.
And he has done as well. Good work there from Bobby Pallett to hammer fist his way through.
And he'll see this round out, no doubt, you know, one up, because he's done some great work from the top. Bonner has threatened a little bit from the bottom with a couple of arm bars, but most of the work coming from Pallett.
Yeah, I mean, it was a lot of work from Pallett. I think the pressure was put on by Bobby. But obviously, Bonner went for two really nice submission attempts. The second one got completely nullified with a hammer fist. And the first one was close, very close. What's that transition like, though, Jake, moving from amateur to pro?
Yeah, I mean, you know, when you're a very experienced pro, as Pallett was, it's not like a huge chasm to fill, as long as you've got the fitness to go the fives instead of the threes. I mean, Pallett's had decisions at amateur where he's done the three-minute rounds, but when you start flagging at the end of a three-minute, you're trying to get to the five-minute, it doesn't feel like 2 minutes longer, it feels like 10 minutes longer. You know, but I'm sure he's worked hard at getting his fitness up, and he's looked good there the first round, looks pretty fresh, ready for the second, and for me, that's one of the biggest leaps you'll make. Bonner looking pretty relaxed in the opposite corner as well.
Yeah, I think fitness is never in question for especially for Bonner.
Oh, straight out, straight throwing the shots as well.
Like I said, they really don't like each other, these two. I'm not too sure what's going on with it, but they definitely don't. It always adds to that fire if you're fighting someone you don't like.
Yeah, exactly, and you can see that as Bonner come out for the second round. He wanted to get straight in Pallett's face, looking to set up the kicks now. Oh, nice straight left in a roll there from Pallett.
Yeah, good work.
I mean, Bonner's got that odd style. He stays in the pocket, just keeps throwing. Not much seems to faze him. He's got a decent set of whiskers on him.
Yeah, I think...
I won't use the politically incorrect term that I was thinking, but I'm sure you know what I mean when you're watching this.
Good work from Bonner on the back foot, though, at the minute. He's blocking quite a lot that's coming in, but Bobby is just putting the pressure on, piling it on now.
Yeah, Bonner looks strong from there, like pushing his way off, but good work from Pallett. I mean, maybe Pallett is finding the... Oh, as I say that, I was just going to say, maybe he's finding the weight difference, something to contend with, and he picks Bonner up and slams him to the mat. So, pretty comfortable with the weight, it would seem.
Yeah, absolutely. This way, he needs to start elbowing now, and he starts throwing them elbows. Start looking for that wrist grab and then throwing that elbow over the top.
Yeah, once you realise you can throw them, then they start coming. I mean, you do forget when it's something you've never done before. You can't really do it in training, you know. So when you get into the fight, it's the first time you're really throwing full power elbows.
But then you can end up like Matt Inman in his last fight, breaking both elbows.
Yeah. Look, guillotine, jumped on a guillotine. That looks tight.
That's very tight.
And Bonner might go out there. He's trying to fight the hand. He's doing all the right things.
He's got a slight gap, but he could pressure his way to.
And you can see him fighting the hand there, trying to give himself a little bit of space, and he's popped out.
I was just going to say, he could pressure his way out there with the head, and he has done. And this is where Bobby's now in a bit of a bad position for 3 minutes, where normally it would have been a minute. This is where the difference is now.
Yeah, and you can see Bonner going straight to work with the elbows. And you can see that he doesn't need posture to be able to hit Bobby now. With elbows, he can stay there and he can just chop the little short shots away.
Totally different fight to his last fight for Bonner. Last one against Moshe Slaney.
Yeah, and Bobby trying to work from the bottom. You know, he did land a couple of elbows himself. Little short chopping elbows there.
Yeah,
you don't want to get too caught up in throwing from the bottom. If we if there's an escape or a stand-up there.
Yeah, and I think that's a good little hip escape there from Bobby.
Yeah, that's the right movement. He's going to get up to his feet. He is, great and out work to the back. Beautiful. And someone's opened up a cut with them elbows. Like I said, it doesn't take much. I think it might be Pallet who's bleeding.
We'll see how he deals with that blood.
I think it's the nose, actually, of Pallet that's bleeding. As Bonner goes for the sweep, this could get a bit slippery because there's quite a lot of claret flowing there from Bobby Pallet.
Watch his guillotine now. He might jump for the guillotine. Although,
10-finger guillotine if he can get it in the bed basket. He gives it up.
Turn into a messy, real messy fight this now. Jay, exactly what we sort of expected, really.
Yeah.
Oh, nice left hand there from Bobby.
Beautiful, but Bonner bites down on his gum shield and comes straight back. Again, he just plows forward. He seems to be totally unfazed by whatever shot you land, as clean as you want to land it. And looks for the nice short elbow there on the break. And Bobby replies in kind. Look, these guys are enjoying the pro rules. Going elbow for elbow.
Both just throwing elbows at will there.
I think it took them 5 minutes or so to realise they were allowed to do it. And now they're both, you know, going for broke. Good. Another takedown for Pallet.
Good takedown there from Bobby Pallet.
And Bonner looking with the short chopping elbows from the bottom. Pallet is going to... Oh, just going to say he's going to rally at the end. And he does, goes to the back.
40 seconds left.
A little bit high there. He's trying to establish the seatbelt grip first, but he's using the punches.
Yeah,
he's put the body triangle on.
He's got it locked up. These very long limbs of Bobby.
Now mount.
And this could be a finish.
Big right hand coming in from Bobby Pallet. And we know Matthew Bonner is very tough. But sometimes you're too tough for your own good.
This is good work from Pallet. And again, you know, great start to round. A bit of an iffy middle, but a fantastic finish.
Yeah, it's come on strong there. 10 seconds left in the round. And, you know, Bobby Pallet really managed to turn that round in the last minute in his favour.
Bonner looks a bit demoralised by that. The end to that round was very good from Bobby Pallet there.
Yeah, you see Bonner there getting up, very unsteady on his feet. I mean, that second round really has taken its toll on him. Look at him, if you see him there, he's looking a little worse for wear after that really deep breathing.
What a night of fighting it's been here at Cage Warriors Northwest Academy. In our new home here at the Echo.
Yeah, we've been some excellent fights. Obviously, a big supporting undercard of amateur fights. We've seen some guys who we're going to be seeing a lot of. Some excellent young fighters from some of the top gyms in the region. And now on to the pros. And this is an excellent fight at hand with 5 minutes left to play.
5 minutes left indeed, and this is the time of the fight now, where two brand new pros are going to show what they're made of.
Bonner started every round aggressively, comes in, Bobby Pallet tries to run for the single.
Yeah, trying to work that single now straight away. He's got a lot of blood coming from the nose though, a hell of a lot of blood actually.
Yeah, I think Pallet's realised at the end of that second round the control he can assert over Bonner on the ground. He's quite comfortable working him from there, and there's another big pickup and a big slam for Pallet.
Yeah, great slam there from Bobby Pallet. As he was doing that, the slicing elbows were going in from the side. But
yeah, I remember being massively disappointed in my first pro fight because I didn't get to elbow somebody because they walked into a guillotine. Well,
these guys have
thrown about 100 elbows each. Pallet is getting his fair share of that in. But is Bonner going to come out to the back there?
He's to the back beautifully, but I tell you what, good work from Bobby to see that and spin back out.
Yeah, the sweat and the blood just lubricating things up. Minute down in the final round.
Yeah, this is good work. This is top work from Pallet.
And both these guys
just demoralised there, I think, with his wrestling. He's not really got much of an answer to it, apart from the armbar that he threw up last time.
Yeah, and to come so close and have something so tight, and for that not to work is also pretty demoralising, Jamie, I'm sure. And he's worked well back up to his feet, as Matthew Bonner. But Pallett staying on him, staying really tight, looking for another takedown. But of course, this is energy intensive for both guys. Getting deep on the underhook there was Bonner, just to lift Pallett up and not allow him to get that takedown the second time.
Yeah, he's still trying to work for it. He's doing everything right that he needs to do here, Bobby, really. He's won the first two rounds, in my opinion, and he just needs to ride this out now.
You know, yeah, nothing silly from this point. You don't want to give a fight away at this point.
Well, Bonner needs to do the complete opposite and go for something now. Push him off. Try and work away from that cage.
Yeah, he can't allow Pallett to just ride these rounds out. If he just is half the round gone. Nice little elbow there. Half round had gone and he needs some urgency, does Bonner. Unless he's content to lose
great
the fight.
Takedown.
And another great takedown for Pallett.
And the face says it all from Bonner. Absolutely demoralised here. You know, and he's got 2.5 minutes to rectify this. Otherwise, it's another loss in the column for Bonner, and it's a debut win for Bobby Pallett, in my opinion.
Yeah, and you know, we've seen Bonner can throw stuff up in an instant and come close, but has he got the energy left? Has he got the reserves in the tank to keep attacking from his back? At the moment, it doesn't look like it.
He looks very, very tired now.
I mean, as I say, that throws up a triangle, but Pallett's away.
It was a very tired triangle low attempt.
Nope.
If you look at the attempt of the armbar in the first round, both guys were dry, no blood. Now it's, you know, very slippy in there, sweat, blood.
Yeah, and it's pretty much all gone downhill for Bonner from there. But as I say, that worked back up to his feet. Pallett in again for the takedown, but, you know, a little bit of the zip and a bit of the speed left out of his attempts as well.
Bonner just looks too tired to do anything. This is the thing. He seems, as he comes in, he's happy to sit against the fence and ride and let Bobby ride this out. He needs to do more if he's going to try and win this fight, because at the minute, this is a great, great fight from Bobby. He's done everything right from start to finish.
Yeah, and it's important in the first one, taking a tough first professional fight, it's important for him to, you know, just get the notch in the win column more so than anything else. I mean, not just a notch, but it's been a good performance from him as well.
Dropping them knees into the midsection. 50 seconds left. Not long now.
Yeah, and I think from this point in time, it's just a case of trying to ride this out for Bobby Pallett. He doesn't want to give anything up. But as I say, that Bonner, good work back up to his feet. Still finding that last bit of energy to try and work. 30 seconds, the clock is ticking, and it's not ticking in his favour. And a big dump. Bobby Pallett, we were saying, you know, is he going to have the gas for 5-minute rounds? Is he going to be able to do it? And there, 20 seconds left in the fight, and he's throwing Matthew Bonner on his head.
Oh,
he's,
absolutely.
He's answered those questions.
He's kept the furious pace up from start to finish. Too little, too late, throwing up his legs there from Bonner. It's a big push from Bobby now.
And it looks a bloody mess, but there's no doubt he's taken the win tonight. 15 hard-fought minutes, but that's a very workmanlike debut performance for Bobby Pallett, and he'll get a debut win for his troubles.
Absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of back and forth mixed martial arts action, we go to the judges' scorecards. And the judges have scored this contest a unanimous decision in favour of the red corner. Bobby Pallett.